What's up?
LiQWYD is back. I am back with the review for a highly anticipated YA read, Again But Better. I'm just gonna preface this with saying I probably wouldn't have picked this up if it wasn't for the author. I love Christine. She is one of my favorite booktubers. I loved watching her writing vlogs. They were so fun. But basically the book is centers around Shane, who is the main character, who is going on a study abroad trip to London. Again But Better starts with our main character, Shane. She is on a trip to London to start a study abroad program she signed up for. It is not what she is going to school for because she is interested in writing. On this trip, she meets this dude bro, and immediately she's just like, this is it, this is the guy. That's the one I want. He has a girlfriend, but she picks him anyway. She wants to give herself a chance to pursue what she really loves despite what her parents want. Her parents want her in the medical field so that she'll have a job right after college, and because her parents are paying, she doesn't have much of a choice. So she has deceptively gone on this trip. She now wants this dude bro. And I did read the whole book, I swear. I think the original summary mentioned something about magic, like with a touch of magic, a little bit of magic. But it felt like I didn't expect actual magic to be in there. So heads up, there is magic in there. That's not even a spoiler. That should have been in the more so in the summary. It follows her on her trip. It goes through. It was too long because the Again But Better part is she goes back in time. So it goes through the first half of the book is she goes all the way to the end where she's about to marry this dude she doesn't even like, and then she goes and meets up with her love interest from the study abroad trip because they live in the same city, and then they get sent back in time. So half the book is that, the first time around, and then the second time around is the other half of the book. It didn't feel different enough for me to actually enjoy it the second time. Like, it was fun, but it wasn't all that interesting. However, I did like the setup to the magic part, because she keeps seeing this woman in on the plane to leave. This first time she's just at the airport, and then at this coffee shop, and then I think one or two more times after that. Basically, she gives them a locket. They can open it when they're ready to go. If they want to, they have to meet two requirements. They have to be ready to go, both of them, and then they have to basically kind of come to an understanding of where they went wrong. And they can return, and when they open this thing, they can return to the present that they currently know, or they can literally do everything over again, relive their lives. Honestly, I'd probably do that just because. I'd be like, guess who's betting on the lottery now? Guess who knows who's gonna win these things? Guess who's suddenly a gambler? But they're given that option, and neither one of them through the second half of the book is... Shane is ready to try this again. She's like, yeah, let's do this again. Love interest, not so long. I picked this book up solely because it's by Christine. My biggest issues with it were some of the writing was very awkward. Some of the similes and metaphors she made were just weird. She at one point calls a plane a hollowed out pen, and then describes the Eiffel Tower as Tinkerbell threw up on it. Which, all for creative license, but I even took count and asked several people their thoughts on that description of the Eiffel Tower, because it was supposed to be a romantic moment, and throw up is not romantic. So just stuff like that really kind of put me off and took me out of the story. I'm like, what? Who says that? The whole book in and of itself felt very self-insert Wattpad-y, which I personally don't have an issue with, like, a character modeled after the author or the writer. But it was just, it was too much, in my opinion, here. And I read for enjoyment, not necessarily critical analysis, although sometimes when a book hits just right, I'm just like, I need to know everything about it. This was not one of those books. It sounds like I absolutely hated it, and I didn't hate it, I swear I didn't. I finished it, I did listen to the audiobook, and the person who did the narration was amazing. She did a fantastic job of adding some life to it, because I tried reading the ebook version of it. I had trouble getting through that, but the audiobook version, the narrator did a fantastic job. Highly recommend that. I got mine, I listened to mine on Libby. I like to use Libby and Hoopla. And then if you sign up for Audible, you get the first month free, you get 2 credits. Audiobooks are $22 a pop, minimum, from what I've seen. You can occasionally get them on sale, but like a new book will be about $22-ish, not a lot. So I utilize that free thing, and then I utilize Libby and Hoopla a lot for my audiobooks, because I can't afford audiobooks. I can barely afford the paperback books. See all that? That was like $300-something, and I bought that all at once because I was impatient. While I didn't hate this book, I didn't love it either. I didn't love it, I didn't hate it, I didn't feel any strong emotion about it. And I gotta feel something for it. Like, you're writing a story, I wanna have a strong opinion about it. I wanna love it or I wanna hate it. When I'm just neutral, it's almost worse than if I hated it. Because if I hated it, I at least remember it. I took the time, I'm just like, I hated that part, but that part was good. So, take that as you will. If you're a Christina fan, 100% go for this. You're gonna want to read it regardless. Like, I wouldn't read it again. I just wouldn't. I didn't like it enough. It just, by the second time around, it felt very repetitive, which I mentioned already. It had multiple chapters that could have been cut out. And that's not a good thing when you're writing a book. Everything needs to feel important and vital. One of the most off-putting and Wattpad-y feeling things, was that it had so many references to Harry Potter and Taylor Swift and just multiple things like that, that it felt like they're just trying too hard to place a moment in time. When one of those would have been plenty. I think she was mentioning like Twilight too. And the character is so obviously Christine, which is not in itself the problem, but it's trying too hard to portray something that it just was basically saying, and that was just another thing that made it feel repetitive. One of my bigger problems was it had such homewrecker vibes, because she was going after a dude that already had a girlfriend. And just because she was just like, oh, he's gonna break up with her. He didn't yet. You gotta back off. You could've gotten hit on one of the locals, and that probably would've been a fun story, honestly. Again, I didn't love it. I didn't hate it. I really wanted to, because Christine does such a beautiful, amazing job of telling her stories on the video and on camera that I will watch the same videos over and over again just because they were fun. And it was just a little disappointing that didn't translate into her writing, and she just needs more time to hone it. And honestly, a lot of it is the editor's fault and her writing team. Like, she was published traditionally and she had access to all these things, and I don't know if maybe it was her, like, I don't want to change that, I need that, that needs to be in the book, that you can't cut that out. I don't know if that was it. I think the writing team relied too much on the fact that she had an audience and that people were going to buy it regardless of how good or bad it was. I really genuinely look forward to seeing more of her work, because it wasn't without talent. The concept was fun. It was just, there were things that could have been tidied up that were really her team's job to do and to tell her. And it's always our own job to hone our own craft, but if they're saying, oh, we're going to publish your book and we're going to give you this team, it needs to be used. I love Christina so much. I'll continue to support her through anything. Her second book came out June something-ish. But I definitely will be reading that too, even though this book didn't do it for me. I want to give her another chance, and I will honestly continue to keep giving her chances, even if the next one isn't as great. I hope to see improvement. I'm not going to sugarcoat my review of it or anything, but I hope to see improvement. I do look forward to it. So that is, I would, 3 stars. 3 stars. 2.5, 3 stars. I give this book a 2.5 to 3-ish star rating just because it was fun. I didn't hate it. 2 stars would be too low. I feel like I don't think that would be fair. I don't think this book deserved the hate it got. I would recommend this book to anybody who is a Christine fan, anybody who loves a study abroad story, but who focus more, don't read critically, but read for fun, and want to hear a study abroad romance story, basically. All I can really say is I wanted to love this book, and I didn't, and I just look forward to seeing more of her work. Thanks so much for joining me today. Her next up, I will be reading Better Together, which I don't believe is a second book, but I could be wrong. But peace. Side note, side note, side note. If you do love this story, which I recommend you always give a story a try, you never, in my opinion, is completely invalid to somebody who loves it. Following the same kind of concept, London Boy is my book that came out June 16th. It follows the story of Evie, a study abroad student who is going to London to escape her home life and fulfill 2 goals, a distraction and to nail that internship. It is a YANA, so young adult noodle, contemporary coming of age romance. It deals with, it does have a trigger warning in the very beginning. Not in this copy, apparently. No, here it is. Trigger warning, this story contains elements of unaliving, alcohol abuse, and mentions of mental health struggles, as well as elements of self-harm. Not necessarily physical self-harm, but like self-sabotage. So nobody does anything physically to hurt themselves, but definitely set themselves up for failure, which is a form of self-harm. It is dedicated to my mom. My copy got, you can't really see it in the light, but the yellow parts, I put it in with my highlighter because I was going through and marked it up. Is that this way? But this was not the final copy of it. This is my copy that I first got. But it has pictures of my mom in here who the book is dedicated to. And a lot of you know, if you follow me on Wattpad, that she passed in November of 2020. So, I did dedicate the book to her, but link to this will be in the bio. I'll be having a promo video up soon that kind of goes a little bit more in depth in it without the ending spoilers. And I just really look forward to getting my own reviews, my own book reviews on it, and booktube reviews on it, even if they're good or bad. Not everybody's gonna write everything you like, and I know Christine understands that as a booktuber herself and having reviewed hundreds of books herself, good and bad. So thanks guys for joining me so much. I will see you around. All links will be in the description below. Check out my book talk, my bookstagram, and my book itself. Peace.